Our praises to the Most High. Today we will take a look to the or at the fact that actually Timothy was a Jew by his father, not by his mother, as we can see in the Torah, in the whole Bible, that the Bible is patrilineal. Maybe somebody has not the right context about Timothy, because Timothy was actually a Jew by his father, not by his mother, as the fake Jews want to tell us, and Hamites want to tell us, okay? You see? So there's always a reason, okay, why God is telling us something what the fake Jews and the Hamites maybe don't know or are keeping for themselves, you see? So, especially the, what should I say, some people, groups of people know it, okay, but they won't bring it out because they want to spread confusion around in Israel, especially Israel, okay? You see? So, we have we have this in Israel, okay? So the fact that you are what your father is, especially in the Torah, not hard to understand, okay? And for myself, I know many brothers from Israelite fathers with heathen mothers. Don't matter if Hamite or whatever, okay, but heathen mothers. And I know not one brother in the truth, okay, who has a heathen father and an Israelite mother, and he's gathering Israel. I don't know one, okay? Not even one, okay? And that is a proof for itself, okay? But you will see it anyway, okay? You will see. That's just something what I say about this, what I wanted to say, okay? Sometimes it's important to add something, to add something like this to it, okay? But for the most part, we will go into the Bible, okay? That means study. To show yourself approved, okay? And here we have Timothy, okay? And as I said, Timothy had not just a Israelite mother, but also a Israelite father, okay? Just because you reading Greek here, okay, don't mean that his father was actually a Greek by a native Greek or something like that. Because what you have to think about is, especially if you read in the New Testament, okay, especially, look, we have the table of the nations, Okay, that means you have the son of Isaac and the son of Abraham, the son so and so, okay? And you're always reading about the nations where the people are from, okay? And you don't see in the so-called Old Testament, you don't see Greek there, okay? You don't see like and from this family tree, the Greeks came from, okay? That's that's the big problem, okay? What people have when they read something, okay? They don't know the right context, or they don't know anything, okay? So actually, there is no Greek, okay? Greek was a name that was invented, okay? Very much later. Okay. So if you look line from Abraham to maybe Isaac, okay? There you go. You have Zimran, Yoksan, Midian, Isbak, Shua, from Keturah, but all from Abraham. Then you have Sarai, Isaac, Rebekah, Jacob, and Esau. So Esau was the majority in the Hellenization, right? Where you have like Herodes from, okay? Herodes was from the seed of Esau, or he was like an Edomite, okay? So you have like this, okay? And Herodes was an Edomite, okay? But Timothy wasn't an Edomite because his father was an Israelite, okay? As I said, you don't see here like Greek or something, okay, in the table of nations. That was invented later, okay? And that's why we have to look what a word means, okay? You can't just go by something what you read, okay? So even the people there, they already knew that the father of Timothy was a Greek, but not by but not native born, or just or not by ethnic reason, but for Hellenization reason, okay? So he lived like a heathen, he lived like Gentiles, he spoke Greek, okay, ancient Greek, and he spoke the same language as the Greeks, but he was not a Greek. So the people only would knew that he was a Greek because he, right? Because he acted like a Greek. Okay? You see? So if you think a little bit, okay, you will see that most people don't even understand things like this. Okay? So they only would knew that he was a Greek if he acted like a Greek. They wouldn't know, yeah, he's a Greek by ethnic line, okay? That's not true, okay? That's not true, because we know that Timothy was a Jew by his father, not by his mother, okay? And that's the reason too why he learned the customs or the Torah, okay, from the Israelites to his mother, because his father don't have the truth, don't have the Torah. He maybe was too busy, okay, to live like a Greek, but he wasn't a Greek, okay? He lived like a Greek. That made him a Greek, for what it's written, okay? But actually ethnic, an ethnic basis, he wasn't a Greek, okay? You see? Because if he was a Greek, actually by ethnic line, what is not even logical, because Greek is, as I said, not an ethnic line. The Greeks were Edomites, okay? You see Edomites around Israel, okay, and so on and so forth. So that's even stupid, but but you see that his father was too busy, okay, with the Greek customs, okay? So actually the people around him believed that he assume that he is a Greek by his way that he acting, okay? So he had to learn the Torah from his mother. That would not mean that a woman should teach or something like that, okay? We see clearly that the woman has to be quiet, okay, when it comes to conversation, okay, about the Torah and so on and so forth, okay? But it means that a woman can teach a child his own, can teach her own child about things, okay, in the Bible. That's not a problem, okay? You see? And that was the point here. Because we don't see any Jew in the Bible, okay, who had a Israelite mother and a heathen father, okay? You can tell me one if you see one, but I don't, okay? And when I look today on YouTube and so on and so forth, okay? The same, right? 100%, okay? So you have actually people who are more Jews than people that that are having like two Israelite parents, okay? But it doesn't matter, because the father is the important part here, okay? So if you look up the word here, you see the Greek word Helen, okay?
Strong's G, 1672, Helene.
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 Okay. It has a root, okay, in the etymology. So it's always important for you to look things up, right? Because you have to study, okay? That's just what the Bible is saying us, okay? It's important sometimes, because there are some simple lessons, okay, what you have to understand before you go somewhere and tell them what you think, okay, what is not even in the Bible, okay, or in the Torah especially, okay. So guys, some guys outside here, okay, they're just funny, okay? They don't know what they're talking about, okay? See? But that's just the fact, because they don't have this truth, and they are not Jews, okay? They are Hamites or Edomites or, wait, or Simronites or Joksanites or Midianites or Ishbakites or Shuashites, okay? We have many nations, okay? And you see that they, okay, are not from Jacob especially, okay? Because they would understand some things, okay? But that's just another proof, okay? that some people are just not in this truth, are not even Jews. Okay? But I would say this for sure, okay? I'm sure about that, okay? Because some things are just not for the heathens to understand, okay? You see? So they talk so they go on with their stupidity, okay? But the problem is they come up with the stupidity against our people, okay? The real truth of the Bible, okay? You see? And that's why I'm showing you this, okay? As I said, there is no Jew with without an Israelite father, okay? You see? Outline of biblical usage. A Greek either by nationality, whatever a native or mainland or of the Greek islands or colonies. Entweder, okay? Also das ist... Sorry. I actually want to talk English. So he's, yeah, you see, and in the second sense, okay. Here you have, in a wider sense, the name embraces all nations, not Jews, that made the language, customs, and learning of the Greeks their own, okay? The primary reference is to a difference of religion and worship. Okay, that means nations that are not Jews, okay? And they act like, or they act in the customs language, as I said, okay, religion and worship, like, yeah, exactly, like the Edomites, the Greeks, actually, okay? So Timothy was not an Edomite, okay? For sure, Timothy was not an Edomite. That means his father was not an Edomite Greek, but his father was an Israelite who was Hellenized. That means he lived like the heathens, but he was actually not a heathen, okay? Because if that was what it means, okay, then Timothy actually aren't a Jew, but that's not true, okay? Timothy is a Jew, because we know that the seed line of the father is decisive for your heritage, okay? And for you, for the way you're acting, okay? We see it in the truth today and in the ancient times, okay? If you look Ephraim and Manasseh today or back then, you wouldn't even see that they are that they had a hidden mother, okay? You wouldn't see it, right? So yeah. But you would see that they have a Israelite father for sure, okay? That's something you will see. Better believe me, okay? So if you look on other verses here, I show them to you, some important verses. Acts 16:1. Then came he to the Derbe and Lystra, and behold, a certain people, a certain disciple was there named Timothy, okay, the son of a certain woman, which was a Jewess and believed, but his father was a Greek. Okay, so we don't call our Israelite brothers and sisters today Jewish people. Okay, that's an invented term. Okay, we're not Jewish, we Jews. Okay, that's what the heathens call themselves. Okay, Jewish. There you see even the word Jewish, okay? So they wish to be Jew, right? Oh, man. Man. But right, here you see, and believed but his father was a Greek. And what we have here, the word? G1671. If you read here Greek, okay, it means... it means Hellenized Israelite. When we're reading about Timothy, okay, we know that Paul had writings to Timothy. Okay, he had made writings to Timothy. So there you go, okay? And as I said, Timothy was an Israelite because his father was an Israelite. His father was not an Edomite Greek, and Herodias, okay, was an Edomite. Herodias was only an Edomite. Herodias wasn't like Israelite mother or Israelite father. Okay, Herodias was a Greek only. Okay, you see. So you have a root word. What is important for other verses too? You see, like Gentiles, like Greeks. Okay. And you always have to go in some meanings or some ancient languages to look up the words. Okay. All right, so that was just a quick hit, okay. But here you can see that Timothy wasn't a Edomite, okay, because his father was an Israelite, and yeah. That is actually the true meaning, okay, outcoming from the true or the language that was spoken in that time, especially, okay, or whatever. But that is actually the meaning, okay. As I said, the people around the things happened, okay, they know that he was living like a Greek, okay. They know that he was living like a Greek, okay? He was Hellenized, right? But he was not an Edomite, okay?